You met with the Prime Minister yesterday. Moving on from that topic, I presume you had a chat about The Voice. Was that what you were talking about in Parliament before it started?
We were talking about the motion yesterday that came before the Parliament, okay. The one you referred to before, where the Teals and Greens voted against Israel. So that was the basis of the discussion.
I guess the question in relation to The Voice is why both sides weren't ready for what comes next. It was all pretty clear the referendum would fail. Is there any way forward on recognition? What are you prepared to accept, given the size of the no vote?
Look, we've always said, right back to John Howard, all of my predecessors, we've all had the same view, and that is that we should have constitutional recognition. But you can only do it when you're going to not be assured, but have, you know, pretty close to an assurance that you've got a bipartisan position and success at the constitutional referendum. Now, I think people are well and truly fatigued after the weekend, so nobody's talking about going to that process anytime soon, quite the opposite. I mean, we'd pleaded with the Prime Minister all year to turn the question into one of constitutional recognition, which would have been a unifying moment for the country. Nobody wanted The Voice. He couldn't explain it. He's not, you know, committed now, it seems, to Makarrata and to the treaty and telling the Indigenous leaders one thing and then telling the public something else. So it's divided our country. It's humiliated the Prime Minister. And I think really we need to start now concentrating and cut away a lot of the crap and start concentrating on the practical outcomes for Indigenous people. We need to get kids to school. We need safety. We need a reduction in domestic violence. People work hard for their tax dollars, and those tax dollars should be spent wisely and appropriately in those Indigenous communities and not wasted. And I think that's the focus of the government now. Instead of a 30-year treaty process that the Prime Minister's committed to, or depending on who he's talking to, he's committed to that, at the cost literally of tens of billions of dollars.
Look, I asked you on Friday if you'd walk away from a second referendum. You were never going to do it, right? I mean, and the PM attested yesterday that you're all trailer and no movie. Is that true?
All trailer, no trash. So depends on depends on your perspective.
A bit like Sharknado 4, you know, all trailer, no film.
Well, there's a few examples of that. And it's a bit of a pot calling kettle black at the moment, hearing that from Anthony Albanese. But look, I think the time now is for the practical outcomes. We've had a position where we've said if there's bipartisan support for recognition, if the Indigenous leaders support it, then I think the public would support it. And that would actually have been the outcome that would have united our country last Saturday instead of the division we've ended up with.
All right. Good to talk to you. Thanks, Pete. Sarah. All out of The Voice to Parliament referendum has left major policies for Indigenous Australians in doubt, as Prime Minister Anthony Albanese would not confirm if he would pursue a treaty despite earlier pledges. Mulindiri, the PM is staying silent for the next 7 days. Is it all done?
This is a chance for me to reach out to Australians across the country, Carl, and I do appreciate that opportunity this morning. And I know that there are so many millions of Australians who are hurting, certainly First Nations people who've, in the Yes campaign in particular, who've gone silent this week, and I certainly understand that. But I do know that we have to rebuild. The Australian people have spoken. I am very pleased, though, Carl, that First Nations communities voted overwhelmingly in support of The Voice, and we are naturally reaffirmed in that push to see The Voice in the Constitution, and sadly, we were defeated.
So will you be still supporting, will he be still supporting the Uluru Statement in full? The Makarrata Commission has not been established yet. Will that go ahead? And I guess we're all trying to figure out what he does now and what you will support as a party moving forward.
Sure. Look, they're reasonable questions. I would just say this, though, that we do need some time now to regroup. To actually have the opportunity to be with First Nations people over the coming weeks to see where they're at and what they want to do. And we will take our time on this and we will give our response in due course.
Neil, what needs to happen here?
We haven't got time. I mean, the Prime Minister said earlier this year the problems are urgent. I mean, we can take time to decide what to do. The minister said, oh, the next few months. How many people die in the communities in those few months? How many women get bashed? How many people get locked up? This is an urgent problem. We know it's an urgent problem. There should have been plan B from day one. I cannot believe that we're just putting it all aside. Let's have a think about it for the next 6 months. This is an urgent problem that's existed probably for decades. We've finally got this turning point in the country. We've finally got people recognising, yeah, they voted against the voice, but the people now recognise the urgency. Act on it. Use the momentum. Get out there. I don't know, get a bipartisan group, whatever.
Yeah.
This Indigenous disadvantage has to be fixed.
And just
urgently.
Mulindiri, how do you respond,
Neil,
to that?
Hang on, Carl. I need to respond to Neil there. No one knows this urgency more than I do, Neil. And no one knows this urgency more than First Nations people.
Of course,
what do we... But people are feeling absolutely hurt right now, deeply disappointed in their fellow Australians. They need time to mourn, as the First Nations have said in terms of their silence this week. And this is the cultural difference between how people need to recover from this. You have to give them time. In terms of my role and in terms of
the government's role, I'm talking about
we
government.
Respect that too. But we also get on, we get on with closing the gap. And that's what we remain committed to. We're steadfast to that. And we will certainly move forward. And it won't be in 6 months. I said in a few weeks.
All right.